قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, in these few moments, بإذن الله عز وجل, we would like to address a matter of importance concerning us as Muslims. And this affair is none other than the khilaf, the differing which has taken place as to whether or not today is the 30th of Ramadan or whether it is the 1st of Shawwal, the day of Eid. And it's important to highlight that this affair is not a matter which is new. From as far back as the time of the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim, and they would be differing with regard to the sightings. Al-Imam Muslim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he reports a narration on the authority of Quraib ibn Abi Muslim al-Qurashi, the Mawla of Ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhuma, that he said, أَنَّ أُمَّ الْفَضْلِ بِنْتِ الْحَارِثِ بَعَثَتْهُ إِلَى مُعَاوِيَ بِشَامِ, that Umm al-Fadl sent him to Muawiyah in Sham. قَالَ فَقَدِمْتُ الشَّامِ فَقَضَيْتُ حَاجَتَهَا. So he said, I went to Sham and I fulfilled her needs. وَسْتُهِلَّ عَلَيَّ رَمَضَانِ, and the crescent of Ramadan entered while he was in Sham, وَأَنَا بِشَامِ. فرأيت الهلال ليلة الجمعة. He said, I saw the crescent on the night of Jumu'ah. ثم قدمت المدينة في آخر الشهر. And I came to Medina at the end of the month. فسألني عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما. Ibn Abbas, he asked me. ثم ذكر الهلال, and he mentioned the crescent. فقال متى رأيتم الهلال, and he said, when did you see the crescent? فقلت رأيناه ليلة الجمعة. He said, كريب, we saw it on the night of Jumu'ah. فقال أنت رأيته؟ Ibn Abbas said to him, you saw it? فقلت نعم. He said, yes, I saw it. فرأه ورأه الناس, and the people also saw it. وصاموا وصام معاوية, and the people fasted and so did معاوية رضي الله عنه, as he was a Khalifa at that time. فقال لكن رأيناه ليلة السبت. Ibn Abbas says, however, we saw it on the night of the Sabt, which is after the Jumu'ah. فلا نزال نصوم حتى نكمل 30, and we will continue to fast until we complete 30 days. أو نراه, or we see the crescent of Shawwal. فقلت أولا تكتفي برؤية معاوية وصيامه. He said, Ibn Abbas, will you not suffice yourself with معاوية رضي الله عنه and the people citing it? فقال لا. He said, no, هكذا أمرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, no, this is what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded us to do. Now there are many مسائل فقهية which are built upon this that the scholars discuss, which we're not going to delve into. As a point of reference that we desired from this hadith at this particular point was that Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu and the people of Medina had sighted the crescent of Ramadan on the Saturday, and the people of Sham had already sighted it on the Friday. This shows us the matter is nothing new. However, the way people have taken it and the khilaf and the differing that has occurred in this matter is something which is not praiseworthy. And this is in fact what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions to us in the noble Quran, when he said, جَلَّ وَعَلَى وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِنَ الْأَمْنِ وَالْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. And when there comes to them information of a matter concerning public safety or fear, they circulate it among themselves. But if they were to refer it back to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam and back to those who have authority among them, the proper investigators would have understood it. لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ, they would have known about it. In this ayah, Sa'di says, هَذَا تَأْدِيبٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِعِبَادِهِ عَنْ فِعْلِهِمْ هَذَا غَيْرَ اللَّائِقِ. He said, in this there is a disciplining from Allah for his slaves from carrying out the likes of this unbefitting act. It is appropriate for them when there comes to them a matter from the affairs which are important and the general interests of the people, that which relates to safety and happiness of the believers or fear of a calamity which is upon them, أن يتثبتوا, that they make certainty of the matter. ولا يستعجلوا, and they do not hasten بإشاعة ذلك الخبر, in spreading or circulating this news among themselves. So you can see in this ayah there's a teaching for the believers when a matter like this occurs, that we don't begin to spread and circulate everything that reaches us, as this in turn leads to turmoil, it leads to conflict, and we find ourselves in a dilemma which is unnecessary. However, if we were to return the affair back to the people of knowledge, those who Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed with the istinbat, the capability of deriving the correct conclusions, they would have known about the matter. And in this particular situation that we're in, we will return this affair back to the likes of Al-Allama Muhammad ibn Salih Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, in his fatwa, which covers this exact scenario that we're in today. He was asked, rahmatullahi alayhi, as it's found in the 19th volume of his fatwa, page number 52 and 53. He was asked, لا تمر سنتون. There's not a year that passes في in such and such. It's blank, the country is not mentioned. إلا ويكون هناك جدل حول رؤية هلال رمضان. Except that there is jadal, there's debate about ru'yat hilal Ramadan, the sighting of the crescent of the month of Ramadan, أو hilal Shawwal, or the crescent of Shawwal. وعادةً ينقسم المسلمون إلى قسمين, and the people naturally they become divided into two groups: صائمون ومفطر, those who will fast and those who will break their fast. وبحكم أن البلد ليس بلداً إسلامياً, and seeing that the country that we're in is not an Islamic country. كي يتبع المسلم المقيم أهل البلد, so that the Muslim who's a resident, he may follow the people of the land في مسألة صوم والإفطار, in the matter of fasting and breaking the fast for the Eid. فما رأي فضيلتكم في هذا? What is your opinion in this matter, O Shaykh? وهل تستحسنون? And do you prefer? While the affair is like this, that a student, he fasts and he breaks his fast based on what has been announced in the Mamlaka, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. He responded, فأجاب فضيلته بقوله إن كان هناك رابطة دينية تقوم بشؤون المسلمين فلتتبع هذه الرابطة. If there is an Islamic association that deals with the affairs of the Muslims, then this association is to be followed. وعلى الرابطة أن تجتهد فيما يثبت به دخول الشهر وخروجه. And it is upon this association to strive in that which the entering of the month is known by way of, as well as the conclusion of the month. So there's also an advice to this association that they are striving in reaching the correct position as to when the month enters and when the month concludes. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ هُنَاكَ رَابِطَةً. And if there is no association as such, فَإِنَ الْإِنسَانِ يَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ أَقْرَبَ الْبِلَادِ الْإِسْلَامِيَةِ إِلَيْهِ. That a person, he is then to look towards the closest Muslim country to him. فيتبعها, he is to follow them. وإن اتبع المملكة فلا حرج عليه. And if he is to follow Saudi Arabia, then there's no harm upon him. لأن من أهل العلم من يقول إن الشهر إذا ثبت في بلد إسلامي لزم حكمه جميع البلاد الإسلامية. For indeed, from the people of knowledge are those who have said, if the month إذا ثبت في بلد إسلامي, if it is established in a Muslim country, لزم حكمه جميع البلاد الإسلامية. The ruling of that sighting, it is binding upon all other Muslim nations. ولكن يبقى الأمر المهم. However, there remains an important matter. And give notice to this. أن الناس إذا اختلفوا في هذا الأمر, that the people, if they differ in this regard, فليكن اختلافهم اختلافا واسعا, that their differing should be a differing which is acceptable. It should have room for differing. بمعنى أن لا يكون سببا للعداوة والبغضاء والتفرق. Meaning that it should not be a reason for enmity, for hatred, for division. لأن هذا ضرر عظيم على المسلمين. For indeed, in this there is great harm upon the Muslims. Now just to summarize the speech of the Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentions three scenarios. The first scenario being that there is a Muslim body, an association, a committee and the likes that are diligent and hardworking in establishing the entering of the months as well as the times that they conclude. And if there is that body, then we are to follow. However, in the case that there is no body like that, then we come to the second scenario, which is to follow the closest Muslim country. And we also have the third option of following Saudi Arabia. And the Sheikh rahimahullah, when he mentioned Saudi Arabia, it's important to notice that he mentioned Saudi Arabia in the context of, if they cited it, then we follow because the Muslims, they are from the ulama, those who have taken the opinion that the fast will be established on the entire Muslim nation based on the sighting which is done by a number of the Muslims. So he's bringing in the context that Saudi is the country that's cited, so it's upon the rest of the Ummah to also fast based on that opinion of the ulama. And based on this statement of the Shaykh rahimahullah, those who have broken their fast and celebrated Eid based on the ru'ya, the sighting which has been cited in Somalia, in Somaliland, in Tanzania and Kenya, several East African nations, then there's no blame upon them in this. And for those who have said they're going to continue to fast, being that the closest Muslim country to them did not announce the sighting of the crescent of Shawwal, so they have completed the 30 days, then they also have the choice in doing this. And we remind ourselves as Muslims not to busy ourselves and waste our time and squander our time with qila wa qal, he said, she said, and debate and argument, as this only leads to friction, wal baghdha, and hatred and enmity, and matters that the Shaykh rahimahullah is warning us from as Muslims. But rather this a matter, yasa'u al-khilafu fi, that the differing that has occurred in this affair is acceptable, and it is upon us to practice tolerance to one another in the likes of these matters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us all by what was mentioned, and to accept from us our actions of worship throughout the month of Ramadan, and to make the day of Eid blessed for us and our families, and to safeguard us from every wicked illness and epidemic. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.